Let's see how multi-page documents can be assembled in FlexiLayout Studio. The first thing we want to look at is the FlexiLayout properties. And this is a dialog box that comes up when you first open FlexiLayout Studio. You need to make sure that allow multi-page documents, that checkbox is checked, and that you're reflecting the proper range of pages to encompass the page range that you're going to encounter in your set of documents. In this layout, the header and footer groups are already configured. Each of these groups contains at least one required element. And to be clear, a header must find a string or a combination of strings which are only located on page one, not on any other pages. And that's how footers work too. We must find strings which are only located on the last page of documents. So if we look at the header, we've got some required items. These items would only be found on page one, and this item would only be found on the last page. And you can see the green check mark indicating that those items are required. Let's see how reference assemblies work. Reference assemblies reflect the composition of documents throughout the batch. In other words, the first and last pages are indicated, and the body of the multi-page documents fall between the first and last pages. Reference assemblies allow the comparison of assembly results from document matching, that is, what the header and footer find as the document definition, compares that with the gold standard, which is the actual targeted division of pages into documents within the batch, and those are our reference assemblies. So we can go ahead and manually assemble some documents. Let's go ahead and select images 1, 2, and 3. We'll right click and we'll select assemble the reference documents. And this dialog box indicates that the first page should match our header and the last page should match our footer. And when we do that, we see a blue line encompassing pages 1, 2, and 3. So next up, I've got a 3-page document, which I've looked at before. I know that these are the correct divisions. I'll right click and assemble these two reference documents. And finally, images 7 and 8. I'll right click and assemble this to reference document. And again, the first page is going to match the header and the last page is going to match the footer. Reference assemblies can be set a couple of different ways. They can be set automatically when adding pages to the batch. And this requires that the images ingested already be separated. That is to say, if I have a 4-page document, it should come in as a 4-page TIFF or a 4-page PDF file to begin with. But you can also set reference assemblies manually when all the ingested documents come in as single-page TIFF files or PDFs or JPEGs, but they belong to a larger multi-page document, and that's when we need to go to the step that I just walked through where we manually assemble reference documents. So when we load images here, we've got a dialog box and we have an image preprocessing setting button. And here's that automatic assembly, one document per file. When we ingest with that, if we bring in a multi-page document, this blue banding will be done automatically for you. Now we'll match our Flexi layout with all images in the batch. As we've already defined headers and footers, the pages are now being separated, that is assembled, into documents according to those required elements in the header and footer. And now we'll be able to see the appearance of green brackets. The green brackets indicate that assembly made by the header and footer logic matches our targeted reference assemblies. If it doesn't match, we will see red brackets instead of green. So you see the green brackets here aligning with the blue. There's another way that we can take a look at this. I can right click and I can add a column, the matched sequence number, and this is actually going to give us more and similar information. When you see the H, that indicates we've matched the header. When you see the F, we have matched the footer. So that's yet another way to check that our header and footer are matching our targeted reference assemblies.